Since the early 70s, our next guests have been using technology in their music and pioneered the use of synthesized sounds merged with rock and roll. Joining us via satellite from New York City, from Rush, one of the great bands of all time, here's Geddy Lee and Alex Lifeson. Welcome, guys.
Hello.
Thank you. Hi.
So I just said you guys were pioneers in combining technology and music. Among the first musicians to delve into keyboards and sequencers, other electronics. To what extent do you credit technology for forming your sound and also your success?
Well, you know, there's obviously different kinds of technology. You know, we're, even in our very early stages, we're an electric hard rock band, so we're always dependent on some sort of technology to make our sound as obnoxious as possible. But, you know, as the 70s progressed, we started experimenting with synthesizer sequencers, all those things you mentioned in your nice introduction. And yeah, it became a very important aspect of what we do.
Give us a sense of some of the specific technologies that you guys use to give you really that unique Rush sound. I mean, a Rush song comes on the radio and immediately you know it's Rush, just from the first beat.
Well, I don't know. What would you say the technology advantages? I mean, obviously, being a three-piece band, it's enabled us to explore other areas of sound by using, you know, sequenced strings and choral sounds and keyboards to add much more dimension to what we're doing and still maintain a three-piece format.
Well, yeah, certainly in a live application, that's really important. To create as much sound as possible. I mean, your feet are relatively free, so you should be able to trigger some things with that, and
just like this.
The occasional right hand or this right hand and a left hand to trigger other things.
Do you have two right hands?
And your nose at times to get things going.
Right now, we're looking at the Moog Taurus pedals. That's right. A strange looking instrument. What are some of the more unorthodox things that you use in your shows, technologically speaking?
Well, gee, I don't know. We have a kind of a complex array of foot pedals that trigger a whole bank of samplers, sequencers, and various sounds that are programmed off stage and changed for each song. And I'll trigger some of those, Alex will trigger some of those, and even Neil can trigger them with electronic drums. So the three of us are basically plugged into a bank of computer sequencers, and we have to hit those at the right time in order for it to be in time with what we're playing. So it's kind of a electronic choreography, if you will.
Gotcha. Yeah, well networked on the stage.
I guess this is what you meant. You said, quote, we're so trapped by our technology when you're on stage. What did you mean by that exactly? And because your show is so reliant on technology, has anything ever gone horribly wrong that was beyond your control?
Oh yeah, sure. That's part of the fun. How do you survive when it goes horribly wrong? Sometimes you'll go to hit a pedal and, you know, the wrong song has been loaded, for example. So you'll have the wrong sequence or the wrong keyboard thing. That doesn't happen too often, but...
Yeah, and a quick glance at your crew and make an ugly face at them takes all the blame off you immediately, which is very, very important.
Yeah, it's important to learn the death stare as soon as you can in show business.
So 1976, the album 2112, it's about a future world where sort of technology is in control. The year is now 2003. Do you think technology is too much in control now? Are we sort of spiraling towards a technologically controlled dystopia?
Well, certainly in this studio,
in this
here,
particular environment,
technology has spiraled out of control.
Yeah.
As we're talking to you in another city and there are two robot cameras looking at us, and it's really scary, so... I don't know. You know, technology has to be tempered by the character of the people that are using it. I think, you know, technological advances are important.
Yeah, and the application. Certainly in music, with the advent of digital recording, it's opened a whole new way of working on music, editing. There's instant gratification. You can move things around. You can change an arrangement into... you know, a thousand different things and explore it. But it's not necessarily, you know, a time saver. You can spend a lot more time because of the technology.
I mean, they asked this question of Thomas Edison, you know, when the light bulb was invented. And, you know, he responded by saying, what man's mind can conceive, his character must control. You know, that is certainly, in this day and age, is very applicable to what's going on in world politics. But in the more mundane world of music, the technology has been an incredible benefit to creating, you know, the kind of things we want to create.
Mm-hmm. Speaking of technology, I was snooping around your website, Rush.com, which, by the by, is up for a South by Southwest Web Award this year. And, Alex, you've got some of the most bizarre Flash animation up there. What the hell is Big Al's Tiki Bar all about?
It's just a nice little place to go. Big Al likes to have some guests and make some drinks and spend a nice afternoon drinking, you know, whatever my guests like to have. Certainly not everybody's welcome. But generally, my guests are made to feel very comfortable.
Everyone's trying to break into.
Yeah, everybody wants to come to the Tiki Bar now.
Now, were Gene Simmons and Paul Stanley invited? Were they actually on the guest list? And do they know that you're using their likeness up on this thing?
No.
They can't come in there.
So you got the new album. It's The Spirit of Radio, 1974 to 1987. What can we expect to hear on there?
Lots of songs from 1984 to 1987.
I got it. That's a great name. Hey, Geddy, how about those Expos, huh?
How about them?
You're a big fan, right?
They're hanging in there.
Now we got your old manager, Philippe Alou, here in San Francisco. You're going to have to come by and see a couple games this summer.
Yeah, that's great. He's a great manager. You'll be happy with him.
Yeah, we're very proud to have him here. Thank you very much, Geddy and Alex. And be sure to check out the new album. Thanks for being here, guys.
Pleasure.
Thank you.
To see some of the strangest pieces of musical technology that Rush has used over the years, we've got a great list of them at thescreensavers.com. I will choose free will.